Our last and most complicated and expensive option at the bottom of the waste hierarchy in terms of our materials recovery section is landfill mining. So this is material that we haven't been able to save through source separation recycling, mixed waste processing, MBT. It's in the ground, but we still want to recover it. It's not too late. That's when our landfill mining comes in. And I love the phrasing landfill mining because it really re-envisions waste as a resource. The graph on screen here is showing you the correlation of materials we've extracted on the y-axis versus materials that we have in our products in the x-axis. So we're actually enriching the places that we deposit waste in these valuable minerals that we've been extracting from the earth for years and years and years. So just from a mining perspective, it makes sense to think of landfills as like a valuable ore deposit where we can get all these materials that we've been extracting from other mineral bodies for as long as we've been doing mining. They're all in high concentrations in our waste deposited in landfills. Landfill mining is an attractive idea. It's a way that we can think about righting some of our wrongs that we've done in past waste management and filling in some of those gaps in the circular economy that just doing our forward-facing programs don't work. In practice, it's not applied very often. And when it is applied, it's often not to just get the materials. It's often for other reasons, such as reclaiming the land or reducing the environmental risk. So there's many reasons to do it. Reinjecting materials into the circular economy is not the most important one right now. These projects are usually viable when you need to get rid of the landfill anyway, and if you can add a value out of recovering some of that material, that's when that will be added. There was a systematic study done of landfill mining projects by Zero Waste Scotland. Scotland's a big leader in waste issues, and I've highlighted here. From that same study, here's a table showing what are some of the materials that you can actually recover with landfill mining. So in the middle is the fraction including soil. Soil is shown to be about 55%. So just over half your material is actually just soil. This is something that you don't run into in mixed waste processing. So one reason to try and treat it before it goes into the ground. But on the right, you can see all the fractions that are still in here that you might be able to use. So an appreciable amount of plastic, paper, metals, all sorts of things that you might be able to reinject back into the circular economy or at least use for energy. So just like mixed waste and MBT, a lot of these technologies we introduce for MRFs, we can also use in landfill mining. The big difference is just that there's all this soil and the organics will be a little bit more degraded than you might see in an MBT at the front end. So hand picking, shredding, trommels for size separation, electromagnets, air classifiers, eddy currents, these are all things we've seen before. They just need to be able to handle all this soil that we'll also see. We'll close this section by giving you two examples of landfill mining that actually occurred, one very far and one very close. The first one is in Mosalika, Sweden. So this project was undertaken as part of an academic study looking at waste disposal from an archaeological perspective, which is kind of unique. So the separation technology they used was just three different types of screen, so pretty low tech, and they recovered paper, wood, and other fractions just by processing with screening. The soil they recovered, they retained to reuse. The organics, they put back into another area of the landfill to be able to recover the landfill gas for energy from them. And the plastics were remanufactured into plastic lumber. A second one is a Blackstock landfill in Durham region, which is just near Toronto. And this project was undertaken primarily for land reclamation, but they were also able to take the material with a high calorific value and send it to the Durham York Energy Center, which is one of Ontario's two incinerators, to treat and recover energy from. So for their process, they first excavated the landfill and took out any large tires and concrete. They then processed everything with a trommel, so similar to what they did in Mosalika. The fines fraction they saved to reuse to reconstruct the site, and then the coarse fraction would be all the stuff that is really the waste, not the soil. which was sent to Durham York Energy Center. And through this project, they processed 27,000 cubic meters, which is about two-thirds of the amount of material in the CN Tower. So it's a pretty massive amount, and there's a lot of landfills that are much larger than this. So after carrying out this project, then they just had soil to replace there. They had a much less much lower requirement for environmental monitoring at this site with the waste removed, and are able to reclaim it for green space.